San Diego Comic-Con, we are at some party. We're a band, like, playing, like, a heavy version of Pokemon.
Oh, dude, they were going hard.
This is why I love conventions. Crazy time. Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. And on this episode of Save Point, we got my man in the house, Romy Rome.
What up?
What's going on?
I like how you extend it. Just the, oh.
I have to. Well, here, I'll hit you with this. Romero.
Love it. Love it. So good. How are you?
It's been a while since you've been. I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Glad to
hear
it.
It's been ages, like you said.
Yes, it's been a long time since you've been on the show. So, what was your up, up, down, down nickname?
Romy Rome.
It was Romy Rome? Okay, good.
It was Romy Rome. And might I add that the last time I was on here, I was beardless Romy Rome. And I watched it back and I was like, ooh, babyface Rome. So now I'm going heel beard.
Ooh, welcome heel beard Romy Rome. today we're gonna spend some time chatting about life and things like that while we are playing Captain America and the Avengers. And you have a love for this game, good sir.
I do, actually. Yes. as a kid, so, like, you know, back in the day the comic book stores were, you know, they weren't as abundant back then. And my dad used to take me, and before I actually ever wandered into the comic store, this game used to sit right out in front, and I would spend hours and just endless amounts of money on this game playing it. So I remember beating it too. And then eventually, after I ended up playing this game, I wandered into the comic book store and I found all kinds of cool stuff, but I never went in before.
Oh man. I was very confused. Apparently, I thought I would be shooting arrows, but I'm...
Dude, Hawkeye is low-key fire in this game, by the way.
Yeah, okay. Oh, we can't shoot arrows. Okay. Does it take health from you when you shoot your deals?
It takes health every time you shoot arrows.
Fine.
Yeah.
Okay,
and
so...
And quarters. Just be happy it's not quarters.
Yeah. So as we were talking, as we were getting everything set up to do this, we had like 19 different conversations that I want to go back to all of them. Firstly, we were talking about Shudder. If you don't know what Shudder is, it's like Netflix for horror movies, and it's like my new favorite thing. I've become obsessed, and our good friend Romy Rome has a little bit of a horror background as well, and also enjoys Shudder. You were telling me about a list that you found of the Summerween.
Yeah, Summerween. So, who knows the validity of Summerween, but I'll share this with you. So, my girl Vanessa, she's kind of retroactively found horror. So she, like, you know, I grew up with it. She hasn't. So she's kind of going backwards and watching all these movies. So she wanted to find this list. So she found this list online, and I didn't share this with you earlier, so I want you to hear it now because I want to hear your thoughts since you're neck deep in Shudder right now. So it says, list of horror spooky movies to watch during Summerween. 1, Jaws. 2, Sleepaway Camp. If you've ever seen it, it's interesting. Friday the 13th. Okay. I Know What You Did Last Summer. Us. Mm-hmm. Tourist Trap. It. The 2017 version. The Burbs. Okay. Midsommar. Blood Beach. Awful movie. Piranha. The Evil Dead, Cabin in the Woods, Jeepers Creepers, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, The Hills Have Eyes, Wrong Turn, Jurassic Park, The Final Girls, Ghost Ship, From Dusk Till Dawn, House of Wax, The Lost Boys, Cabin Fever, and Creature from the Black Lagoon. Now, they're all supposed to have summer or vacation themed in it, but I feel like they're reaching a little bit.
That makes sense, because I was just... Like, I was counting the movies that I liked from that list, and I counted 11. And so, but now you say they have, like, a summer theme. Oh, yes, that is accurate. Okay, never mind. I'm going to take my ranking system out of this.
I went to, I watched, Blood Beach the other day for the first time.
Yeah.
And, oh, man, let me tell
We're
you.
We're stuck in a loop. He won't let us out.
I know. Okay. Get us out. It literally starts off with a scene of, wow, I am awful at this game now. It starts off with a scene of this guy talking to this lady walking her dog on the beach. And she gets sucked into the beach. All of a sudden, she's like,
what?
Oh, no.
Sucked into the beach?
She gets sucked into
the
beach.
Like quicksand?
Very slowly. Yes. And like the dog is just sitting there going, arf, arf.
Sounds like a great great film, you know?
Fantastic.
But what have you been doing otherwise, other than watching the Summerween horror list with your lady? What have you been doing to stay sane?
I finally pulled the trigger and got on Twitch.
Yes.
I joined the land of the Twitchers, and I've got to, you know, you've been talking about it forever, and you praising and saying all these things, and I you know, with our touring schedule the way it was before, you know, it's just like I go home and I never really got, but now it's like I was already playing video games anyway, and now I get to hang out with tons of people while I play games, have some fun, learn some new stuff that I didn't know, and it's just been a really cool process.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. It's fun to see everybody kind of now taking a liking to it, because they realize like, oh, we can't really do anything else, so it's like, yeah, we may as well. And they go, oh, that's why people do this, because it's really fun.
Yeah, it's funny. I pulled the trigger and I got on there, and like Drew Gulak and I were doing some stuff. And, you know, I've been watching everybody else's stream. But then I feel like everybody at like Raw, like slowly has been like, hey, you got on Twitch, huh? And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, oh, okay, cool. I'm going to give it a try. And then everybody's been slowly going on. And now it's this big WWE community on there. And I think it's so awesome.
Oh, my God. Why is he so... No, no. You beat this. How much money did it take?
So... a lot of money, and it took me a couple years to figure out the ins and outs. I feel like it took me a year in this game. So this is also one of those games that if you stand directly like above him, kind of off at an angle, you can pop him more where he can't hit you when he's not doing the vortex, obviously.
Nice. Look at you. You still got it. What a marksman.
That was like a double blast.
Yeah. So you've been on Twitch playing games. What have you been playing?
So I play a lot of Call of Duty. I've been playing Last of Us 2. That's what I've been kind of. We're both. I'm a little further than you in the game, and I applaud you on your. I'm gonna sit down and finish this in one sitting attempt. I've got literally almost 20 hours logged right now. And I'm almost near the end. I think I have like four more chapters left.
So I feel like I could have done it had I not gotten a migraine an hour in to playing. It definitely made it a bit harder.
that would make things a little complicated.
Yes.
Have you played last? You played the first one, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And Breeze said it's like the weirdest he's ever seen me act in my life. Cause like she came out of my room and just sat at the table. Like I didn't know what to do after I watched the ending. I was like, cause like, what do you do? What are you supposed to do? Like he made the right choice, but he also didn't.
Well, like, I gotta tell you, this game has been no different. It's just been, it messes with your mind the entire game, and you don't, the people you like, you start to dislike, and the people you dislike, you start to like, and you just kind of go back and forth in this rotation of this. And like, I don't even, every time I finish this game, I feel so heavy. Also with jump scares in there, thanks to everybody on Twitch, it makes it that much more stressful.
Oh, yep. Yep. People think it's so funny to scare you while you're playing a scary game.
Oh my God. I added clicker noises to my sound alerts.
No.
And so yesterday I was actually playing and I forgot I added them in there, and I just got past this big boss and I was already stressed out. Like I was super stressed, and I finally got to this part. And you know how like in that game you have those moments where you're like, oh, I can finally breathe. I can finally breathe in this game. And I jumped into the garage and I like was creeping down and all of a sudden you just hear and I was like, oh, and I crouched down and I put my silent thing on and I'm like looking and I don't see them and everybody in chat is just laughing their asses off. I'm like, great.
It's everyone conspires against you.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
It's good, but it's like, oh.
Every time I see a guitar, I just start crying because I know that something is going to happen that's going to just emotionally destroy me. And I don't like knowing that a video game has that ability over me.
Especially the second, like, you already felt that way for the first one, so now you're coming back to the second one and you're like feeling the same way again, and it's like, how? How do you wreck me so hard?
Yeah. Like, I'm a grown man. Like, I have kids. I got bills. I shouldn't be sitting in front of my computer screen just crying like a baby, but I am. Because video games are good, and everyone should play them and respect them. Because they're good for you. Like lunch.
I mean, it's just great storytelling. Lunch. Just great.
Yeah.
it's a sandwich. It's got a lot of pieces. It's got the stressfulness and the happiness and the tears and the 80s songs played on guitar. Just,
it's too much. It's too much. So that's the video games. We talked some horror movies. One thing that I know that everyone has been doing since they've been staying at home is watching a lot of everything. So, Mr. Romy Rome, what have you been watching on your in-home stay?
Man, I've been locked into Disney Plus so hard, it's not even funny. Yeah. I mean, we're playing Captain America and the Avengers. I've been going back and, like, I did the entire Avengers movies, all the Marvel stuff. I did all the Star Wars. I've gone back through and watched the entire catalog of every Disney movie ever. Rick and Morty, you know, just everything I can, man. I've had a lot of time. This was before I got on Twitch, by the way. Now I don't have as much time.
But you were burning through everything. So obviously you went through like Tiger King, all of the big Hot Topic shows.
That was literally my first quarantine buy. Like watch, I mean.
Just digging into it. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Where are we supposed to be shooting? I feel like in the shoulder.
Game over for me.
Okay.
You're so
low. No. No, not like this. Not like this. I can't do this by myself. This is my last life. I'm so dead. If I can even make it to the boss.
So I never played this on Super Nintendo, but I definitely played it on the arcade. It's literally, it's like little minute differences. So the first level, from what I can tell, is pretty close, but everything after that is like slight variances of what it was actually on the arcade. Because I just played through this, a lot of lives, but I just played through this on the arcade. So it's interesting how like just the tiny differences from like Super Nintendo over.
No! No! No!
Get him! I'm taking over now. I'm asking the questions while you play.
Come on. All right, you ask some questions.
All right, so what have you been up to? Because, you know, I see you everywhere, and honestly, a lot of the times we cross over at comic conventions, or I don't think the last time I saw you was San Diego Comic-Con, was it?
Oh, where the fire twirler at the club.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. San Diego Comic Con, we are at some party and there's a band and they are incredible. And at one point they start playing Pokemon and it is like everyone in there is losing their minds. Everyone's just screaming, singing the song, I wanna be lover! And they get done, they're like, oh, thank you. And everyone's just like, yeah, screaming. And then all the lights go out. And then the next thing that we see is this girl spinning fire with a sword, and it was like, how? And I am dead. It was just like, how does that transition occur in real life to like, hey, we're a band, like playing like a heavy version of Pokemon? And then,
oh, dude, they were going hard.
Yes. And then she comes out spinning fire, and I was like, okay, this is a great night.
They were playing like, they had been playing like eight solid 80s jams all night, and then they busted out Pokemon and they busted out something else, and they're like, gotta catch 'em all, and they're like going into it, and then all of a sudden everybody's just, we're all sweating and like, yeah, we just felt like we like sang the concert ourselves. And then the lights shut out, and we at that point I think we had moved down to the dance floor because we were up in that little, that because it was a Stranger Things party. That's what it was. It was Stranger Things theme. And so we went down from the upside down, and we went down into the other spot, and then it just goes dark, and she comes out and she like slow rows us for a little bit. She's like standing there, and then she's like, what up?
Everybody losing their minds.
What? Because everybody was like, bring back the music. I don't, is that the last time I saw you?
No, we had to have seen each other after that at some point. But like, but that's the last time we like hung out. There's so much stuff going on at work.
I remember we were on a boat at the back of Comic-Con, and we're all dancing. And all of a sudden you heard, hey, give it up for my good friend Estelle. And then she starts singing American Girl Live. American Boy, that's what it was. Starts singing that song live, and I'm like, what is happening right now?
That was a weekend. That was definitely a weekend.
Yeah, it was.
This is why I love conventions.
I do too.
What do you miss the most?
Honestly, so I've gone, it's funny, like getting to go to a convention, like just as like normal Austin, like me, to a con as like just a fan, and then going as Mike Rome to a con are very different experiences, like extremely different experiences in general. But so like getting to go to that and meet all these different people from all walks of life, and the cons are like, you know, there's horror there, and there's comic books and video games, and there's just so many different aspects of nerddom there, and you just kind of bathe in it. You're just like, give it all to me. And you just get to meet all these cool people, and you're hanging with all these people, and you're surrounded by things that you forgot that you loved or didn't love. And you get, I think one of the cool things, especially about Comic-Con, you may agree or disagree, is getting exclusives like are awesome, and getting all these things that like nobody else has access to, and getting the news first, like finding out that so-and-so is going to be in this Marvel movie, or this is going to happen. Like I got to sit in a Batman Beyond panel, which is part of the whole reason I went, was an anniversary panel, and getting to see the voice actors up there was just amazing to me. Like I was just sitting there, and it wasn't a full theater. Like, you know, it's such a niche thing, but I was just in there like, this is the greatest day of my life. I just love that stuff, man. It's just so cool. And then getting the parties and like just hanging out. Like I met so many people that weekend that I still talk to just like randomly, or I play with PlayStation online, and it's just, it's such a cool family of people who I feel like when we were younger, people like would give us a hard time. Like, oh, you play video games. Oh, you like Star Wars. Or you like comic books. Boo. And now it's like, yeah, I do. It's such a different time. And we can all come together and like share as a family. And it's just awesome, man.
See, what a wholesome message from a wholesome man. Just a good, happy, wholesome man. Give it up for Romy Rome, ladies and gentlemen. One time.
You know.
We do have to wrap it up, but I want to say thank you so much, Romy Rome, for being on today.
Of course. Thanks for having me, man.
Of course. Where can they find you on the internets, on the social medias?
You know, Mike Rome, WWE, across Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and Twitch.
All the links will be in the description below. Check this man out. He's a good dude. Good brethren. But again, thank you for watching. And remember to always and forever keep it tight. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da